Hey everybody, how's it going? It's the Crystal Flaffy, and welcome to another one of our Shodan Live Battle Sessions. Again in the RU tier, and we are finishing off using our team revolving around our Durant and Clawitzer, the Shattered Glass Cannons. Now, I did mention in the last episode, guys, why we had that couple days delay with those couple days without uploads. So, if you want an explanation for it, just check out the first, 5 minutes, the Mystery Dungeon that went up yesterday, and if you want, watch the whole video, you know, because it was a pretty good one. Anyway, we're going to look for a battle right away, we're going to look for a battle right away. One thing I did forget to mention in the last video that went up, the Mystery Dungeon episode, is that we reached 50 subscribers. I think it was on 22nd, I believe it was the 22nd, where Tuesday the 22nd, where I noticed that we were at 50 subscribers. So I'm really, really happy and excited about that. Let's think of a lead first before we continue rambling. We do have our Sneasel lead, which is always a go-to. Well, we do have our Aerodactyl lead, which is our rocker. And he only has one defogger / spinner in Flygon, so can keep that in mind. But what do I think he's going to lead with? He can lead with Diancie, because Diancie is his rocker as well. As Cofagrigus actually comes out. Should I U-turn or EQ? A Will-O-Wisp is definitely coming. And we do not have anybody that wants to take that. But we gotta U-turn out. We gotta get away from this Cofagrigus, because we do not want to get a burned Flygon going on. Also, going for this U-turn is actually very decent, very good for us, because it still keeps what our Flygon does a secret. Because even the special sets for Flygon run U-turn. It doesn't show whether we're scarfed, banded. Well, it would show that we're not banded because of the damage. But it doesn't show for Scarfed or Specs or anything like that. It does show we're not Life Orb. It doesn't show about Leftovers or anything else. So it was a pretty good play to go for. But we can go into Bandit, who I believe has Dark Pulse. I really hope that it does. No, it doesn't. That's not good. But we got a Scald here. We got a Scald here. Hopefully he'll go out into the Virizion, predicting the Dark Pulse, and he'll get burned. No burn, damn it. I was really hoping for that burn. I really was. But let's see, who do we go out to now? I believe now we can just go out into our Cofagrigus. But anyways, guys, we did hit 50 subscribers, which is amazing. Now, I don't think that I'm gonna have, some special update video about it or anything, because I don't feel like 50 is that big of a number to do so. But I just really appreciate all the subscribers that I have, and I'm happy about it, and I look forward to getting a whole lot more. So just know all my subscribers, I thank you. But we can't stay in there with Cofagrigus, because Blizzard would hurt. It even hurt. Wow. Really? Really, we got frozen. That's ridiculous. That is kind of ridiculous. I don't know what to do now. We needed this thing for Diancie. We do have Earthquake on Flo, but he can kill us with Diamond Moonblast. I don't want to let this thing go down, though. All of our moves are super effective against this Abomasnow, too. We could have killed it if it didn't. We could have killed it too if we didn't get frozen. But I kind of want to keep this thing around. I kind of do. No, there's no point. There's no point. Which would do more if we thought out? Superpower would do 240. This would do 120. They would all do 240. They'd all do the same amount. So we're just going to Iron Head. As in comes his Durant, so he's probably gonna set up right here. He is probably going to set up right here. We're going to superpower just in case. See, he sets up the sub. But we thought. That's nice. That's nice. That's actually pretty nice. And we go down to the hail, which is awesome because since he is not behind the sub, we can do something about it. We can do something about him. We can keep him from getting behind the sub. Did he reveal an item? No, he didn't. So he's probably Life Orb 2, now that I think about it. I don't think a knockoff can kill, no, because Durant is insanely bulky on the physical side. So we've just got to come in here and fire punch. Sucks to be revealing it so early, but what can you do? We got to do this. As in comes the Kefagus, so there goes our Levitate again. We definitely gotta switch. We definitely have to switch. Now, oh man, I can't risk the Willow on any of our Mons. We have a Burn Weak team. That's like something I really noticed that is poor with this team, is we are so weak to Burn. We're so weak to Burn. Maybe we could run a special Flygon. Maybe we can do that, but You know what? After this battle, I'm gonna try switching it up to a special Flygon, and we'll see how that goes. Because we only have one prominent special attacker, being the Peg, being Bandit right here. So we gotta make up for that somehow. Like, sure, we have Hex on our Kefagus, but that does nothing. That's, like, worthless to me. Not worthless to me, it's not worthless to me, but it's not that great. Can we please get a burn? We got a crit, but no burn. And we gotta go back out into our Kefagus, and he's probably gonna predict that and just hard swap back out into the Abomasnow. Which actually really sucks. Because we can't do anything to it. We're going to go down to a Blizzard for sure. So, I don't know. And we do get poisoned, which sucks. That's a bummer. But we... Should I Willow? Yeah, let's Willow. Why did that Leaf Blade do so much damage? That was, like, so ridiculous. And his Lumberry. We're losing our Kefagus here. Yep. That was ridiculous. Well, it was +2, so I understand why I did so much. It wasn't ridiculous. I'm just upset about it. But we can actually go into our Aerodactyl, as we definitely 100% outspeed, and he doesn't know what moves we have. So, I can defog. Let's defog on the switch. There we go. And we can actually get our rocks up here. I don't think this... Well, we're sashed, so he can't take us out. We're sashed. But what do we do with this turn? Do we rock slide? He has -1 evasion, so we can hit for sure. But we're not gonna kill, and I highly doubt we'll get the flinch. Well, it has a 30% chance. Yo, Rockslide has a 30% chance to flinch? I did not know it was that high. Well, we can rock slide or we can tailwind. Now, do we need the tailwind? Double this is 308, so we wouldn't even outspeed that. La la la. So, let's see, we can let him take us out and go for Tailwind. Sash, defog, rocks. Oh, I don't see what's wrong with that. But okay, we're just gonna go for a rock slide, maybe flinch. We did flinch! See, that's what you get for talking shit, bro. That's what you get. You don't speak negatively about a set, especially one that works. Focus Sash, Stealth Rocks, lead Aerodactyl. Come on, that's common. The common set for Aerodactyl to run Focus Sash, Rox and Defog. Rox Light's flinch was unfortunate for our opponent, though. So, yeah, but we're going to Rox Light again, just get some damage off, and then we're going to, if he goes for Rox right now, we're going to Defog him away. But he doesn't go for, doesn't go for the Rox. And I don't think we outspeed with Clawitzer, which sucks. And what an Earthquake kill. It is Leftover, so it is a defensive set. Let's see, Flygon. And we're gonna go with this one. And Diancie. Let's say, are you tank? Specially defensive, Earthquake does 63 to 75. And physically defensive, it 100% does not kill. So, we need to do something else. We gotta go into Bandit, and Bandit has to be able to live this Moonblast. So let's go for a Scald. Let's see, what do we have speed? 238 is our max. So if we're both uninvested, we do outspeed. We do outspeed if we're both uninvested, because he, well yeah, likes to run Diamond Storm as well, so Quiet Nature makes sense on it. So it's actually probably hindering Speed Nature, so we would outspeed it. As in comes the Flygon, please do what you need to do! We did not get a single Scald Burn this entire game! What is this? As we see that it is a Defog Flygon, and we can U-turn again, take it out, and not have to worry about Diancie coming in on the Dragon Claw, because it doesn't affect it. We don't have to worry about that. We got our Sneasel in, for free, actually. As in comes Diancie, which can one-shot us, 100% can one-shot us. But we're gonna swap. We need to get up out. Let's see how much would Clawitzer do with Scald anyway? It would do 53 to 61%. And he would do like 40 tops if he goes for Diamond Storm. Which he does do, and he goes for, gets 40. Gets the defense boost, but that's okay. Can we please get a Scald Burn? Let's count them. We went for 4 Scalds and not a single burn. Can we get one now? No, we cannot. Can we kill? Yes, we can. But now, this is a very tricky situation. It is a very tricky situation. We need this thing for Diancie. Our opponent has a really bad fire weakness. Like, we need Clawitzer for Diancie. We don't need Flow for Diancie. But we can Earthquake here. Sure, Thing resists, but at -1. Let's U-turn in case he wants to swap. Because we do need this Flygon, because it's, like, if he swaps, we do need this Flygon, because it's the only thing that outspeeds the Virizion. I think. No, Weavile outspeeds. Not Weavile. Sneasel outspeeds. Weavile definitely has snakes. Like, ain't nothing to say about it. Let's see. So we do take it out, and we gotta bring in this Clawitzer right here. So he's probably gonna bring out the Bomb Snow, but then we can swap. We can swap right after. Our opponent actually has a Fire Weak team now that I look at it. But we need this thing for this. But, he's definitely gonna go for a Grass Thing, which would kill Sneasel. But I can't let Sneasel go down just yet. Let's see, how much does Sneasel do to it? Do to Diancie. Poison Jab. Okay, Ice Cold Crash does 33 to 40. So plus the 50 from Scald. That can kill. Or let's see, Flygon. How much does the Earthquake do? 60. So actually, you know, we're gonna keep. Oh, you know, we can't do that. We do outspeed. I don't think we do. But wait, this thing is normally quiet, so. No, never mind, we don't outspeed. So we probably lost. If we working on Oko with, you know what, no, I'm not going to calculate, especially because I misspelled Abomasnow. Icicle Crash is neutral, but Poison Jab is super effective. But we do have a chance to flinch with Icicle Crash. So this would be 160, and this would be 122.5. Oh, this is a tough one. Poison Jab, we want to kill. Oh, and Diancie comes in too, so... How much did that knockoff do? Or how much did that whatever move it was do? We did 40% tops, okay. Huh. We gotta hope for the flinch. We gotta hope for the flinch. And we don't get it. No, we lost because Ice Shard kills us. Oh, that was so close. Why did I Earthquake? Now we definitely lost. Even if he didn't carry the Ice Shard, we definitely lost now because we went for Earthquake. But he did carry the Ice Shard, so it's all fine and dandy. We lost anyway. And... Oh, our opponent was really high ranking. Let's see. Where are you? Let's make this quick change right here. We're gonna go Earth Power. Flamethrower. And should I go Dragon Pulse or Draco Meteor? Let's go Draco Meteor. Oh, that's such a low special attack stat. Let's see. It's 40 points lower. We need to give it Modest. We need to. So we're going to try switching it up to a special Flygon. And our opponent is all walls. See, physical wall, mixed wall, mixed wall, mixed wall. Mixed wall. Mixed wall. He has a bunch of walls. Ugh. He has a defogger. Stealth rocker. He has two stealth rockers, actually. So, getting up our rocks isn't that important. Well, it is actually important because he does have a Golbat. I do not look forward to going through this team because it is too bulky. You don't see this bulk in RU, man. Go for Toxic. Why did you not just hit me with a Water Type attack? But let's see. What can come in on this guy? And that would be Bandit. Excuse me. That would be Bandit. We can come in and we can go for the Hidden Power Grass. Which would actually be so cool if we went to the Gastrodon, which he does! Oh, that is perfect. I don't care if you got the wish back. You are not staying in. I'm doing it again. If you stay in, you're still two-shotted. So. And you go for the Toxic, so. Clearly you don't care about... What is this team? All Toxic users? We're gonna Hidden Power Grass again. Registeel comes in, but that's okay. We have Aura Sphere. Our opponent is actually very toxic, has a very toxic using team. But his team actually does seem to be pretty weak to our Clawitzer. But I do gotta switch Clawitzer out now that we've taken so much toxic damage. But let's see, we have Hidden Power Grass for these two. Scald does monstrous damage to you. We have Aura Sphere for you, actually, sorry. And the Scald can do pretty much, can do some work against the other ones. But let's see, who can come in against this Registeel? Registeel. We can come in with Flow. We can do that, which is what we're gonna do, actually. We're gonna come in with Flow as he goes for the rest. I do not like that. But we're gonna Flamethrower. We are going to go for this Flamethrower right now! The fact that we are Choice Scoped is actually pretty damn useless. Seeing as we're already faster than his whole team. But, at least, I don't know. we could have gone specs if we were gonna, if we knew we were gonna face this guy. But we're gonna go into Antony because we do not want this thing toxicking us. And we're gonna start setting up. We have superpower for the Registeel. We have, and he has Scald. Okay, no burn. Do I want to risk one more? No, I don't. I don't want to risk one more. I don't. So let's see. We're not going to continue setting up until this thing is gone. Because we do not want to get our Antony burned. We don't want Antony burned, and we are going to Will-O-Wisp ourselves so we can get somebody burned on his team. That was actually a crit Scald burn too. That is bullshit. He got a crit Scald burn. And in the last battle, we could not get a single Scald burn. I'm pretty sure we didn't get a single one. If we did get one, it was towards the end. I don't remember. But we're going to Will-O-Wisp this Gastrodon. And we're going to miss. Of course we missed. Now this is just a battle. Like, I don't know what's up with my luck right now, but I don't have any of it. And this is definitely especially defensive. Definitely especially defensive, because I did nothing. I did literally nothing. So we've seen Toxic, we've seen Scald now, we've seen Recover. Don't burn me, please. Thank you. Let's Earth Power. Watch Golbat or Uxie come in. Watch one of the two of them come out. We do get the special defense drop, which is nice. But our opponent is definitely going to switch, so we should switch as well. Earth Power, one of these two, so Cerulean come in. Cerulean is coming. Sneasel's coming in. Oh my god, I don't understand. Can we please just kill something? We went for knockoff. Can you just kill it? That was a crit, and it did 39%. This guy is literally just weakening our team. Like, we're slowly but surely getting whittled down. And he's gonna protect right here, so we're just gonna swap back out again. He's just gonna protect, so fuck it. No point staying in. I understand that stall is a legitimate playstyle, but this is ridiculous. When your whole entire team is nothing but wish, recover, and rest, and roost, you're doing something wrong. Draco Meteor. Let's just fucking kill this Gastrodon, please. And that's still only just 35%. Like, four of them on our status. Two of them don't want to be status. Let's Hone Claws. He's definitely going to get a Scald Burn right now, so honestly, if he gets a Scald Burn right here, I am going to forfeit. So, okay. We're going to find another match, because that was ridiculous. That was just ridiculous, so I'm sorry, guys, about that, but I'm not dealing with that. I'm not dealing with a team that is six walls, each with just Toxic and some form of recovery. No, I refuse to deal with that. I don't even care about our score because of that. Now here we go. Here is a legitimate team. Let's see, he can have a wall here. This can be a wall and a Stealth Rock Setter. This can be a special wall. And then he's got some offensive mons thrown in as well. So Thank you for having a normal team. Well, let's see, leads. Let's lead off with our Flygon to get a Choice Scarf U-turn up out, and we threw up the timer. And I really think that he wants to get up his rocks right here. I do. But we are going to go up into our Clawitzer, because if he does attack, which he didn't, we could have lived whatever hit he went for. But we can Hidden Power Grass right here, actually.
We can Hidden Power Grass. There's not really anything that he wants to switch in.
So we can take out that Seismitoad. As you can see, it was a defensive mon. That's Stealth Rock Toxic. But in comes the Manectric. Yo, how badass would it be if we could live one? We are Assault Vested. Manectric, are you Special Attacker? Thunderbolt does 70 to 83%. And we can just U-turn? But no, I don't want to do that. We got to swap. Impower Ice, by far. I know I should have saw that coming a mile away, but I just didn't want to risk it. And a lot of our team is actually faster than this thing. I thought Manectric was actually pretty speedy, but it's not. What is its base speed? It's 105. Oh, shit, sorry about that. I did open up the channel by accident, but as you can see, guys, look, 50 subscribers! Yeah, sorry about that. I did open up the screen by accident, as Exeser just takes it out right away. Oh, Durant, you're so strong. Let's see. Okay, it definitely has a fire type move. Let's go into our Cofagius. Let's see, fire punch? No, earthquake. Okay. And we can Will-O-Wisp, we can do that, which we are going to, but Delphox comes in. I had a strong feeling Delphox was going to come in. But if this thing Psyshocks, Bandit can't really take it, so I don't want to just hard swap like that. But we need this guy. We need him. Well, we don't really need it. We don't really need Clawitzer. As we can comfortably take two Fire Blasts, which is nice. Hopefully he does not have Psyshock. He has Grass Knot, but our Assault Vest lets us live, and we can take him out with a Skull. Nice! That was intense. I keep forgetting that thing can carry Grass Knot. Every single time, I forget. Now, definitely we're going to get faked out right here, so I am switching. As he swaps. Never mind. We're going to Pain Split. His whole team is at full HP, so going for Pain Split is the best option we can do. Now, seeing as the way he's been playing that Flygon, I actually do think that it's Scarfed in some way. That did so much damage! Oh my god, Braviary is so strong! Oh man. Oh, but it doesn't look like Cofagius is gonna be able to stick around any longer. It does not look like that. It doesn't look like that is the case. Let's see, what should we do here? Because I kind of do want to keep this thing around. Whatever, let's just hit. Why did I go for Hex? Why did I do that? Why would I do that to myself? That's Calm Mind. I don't know, just in case. But there's no point. We're dying to whatever mon he sends in. Hitmonlee, are you going to have a move that can hit us? Yes, you do. You have Knock Off, but thankfully you did not have Fake Out. Oh, it was Reckless. Okay, so it's not Unburdened. So we're actually going to see High Jump Kick from this thing, which is terrifying. It is terrifying to see High Jump Kick from this thing. But we got rid of its Reckless, so it's cool. I do want a Home Claws here, because I don't think he's going to stay in. He did lose his Reckless, so I don't think he can kill. And I don't think he thinks he can kill either. I don't think, actually, High Jump Kick did kill. Anyhow, it's bad. What the hell? Tailwind. Fuck, I forgot about the Tailwind. I legitimately forgot about the tailwind, guys. I did. That is my bad. And I think we might have lost because of that. I do. Defog. It just goes for the outrage. Damn, man. Oh, blah. But we can get rid of the Flygon, at least. We can get rid of the Flygon. Well, Tailwind is gone. Tailwind is gone. So unless this thing has priority, we can probably kill it. Can Ice Shard kill, though? I do want to see if Ice Shard can kill, because then I don't have to risk the miss. Then I don't have to risk the miss with, Oh my god, High Jump Kid murders. It does 1,000%. Ice Shard does not kill. Icicle Crash is guaranteed to kill, but he definitely has Mach Punch. I think a high roll can kill the Israel app. Yo, this guy just like spams. Just spams like, do you die to Shard? Oh, never mind, sorry, more than one person. Okay. Finally got what? Well, anyways, guys, we're going to call it an episode right there. Make sure you guys light up that like button down below for me if you enjoyed, and comment, give me some feedback. Let me know what you guys think. If you want to say I'm salty about that second battle with that bulky-ass team, by all means, go ahead. I don't care. I am salty about it. I am mad about it because that was ridiculous. That was so stupid. But also, guys, subscribe if you want to stay updated for the next video. Have yourselves a good day, and I'll see you guys all next time.